Hey everybody, welcome back to another Halloween how-to. Today I'm going to show you how I like to make these decorative Halloween pillows on the cheap. Now I used to decorate with, you know, these sort of throw pillows throughout the house, but they get to be so expensive. And when you're talking, you know, usually you want to put, you know, several, maybe four or so on a couch, maybe more. You know, when you have several seating locations, I mean, I myself have eight sofas in this house. These pillows can get outrageously expensive. So I just started making them myself. Now, it's very easy to do. I don't know how to sew, but I did see a video once on how to make these using hot glue. So I thought I'm gonna show you how to do that today. Now, what you're gonna need to do this are a couple of dish towels. You can get them in a lot of different shapes and fabrics and patterns. I usually like to go for the sets of dish towels that have two different patterns so that you automatically have something coordinating. That's what I did with these, which were my very first pillows I ever made. So they're a little flat, they're a little understuffed. I learned a lot from these, but I'm gonna show you a few more of these in a minute, a few different ones that I made. But I got these from the Big Lots. I can't remember how much they were. I wanna say the two different pattern, you know, dishcloths came together. It was like $3 or so, but the prices really vary. Now, for instance, I picked these up today from the home goods store. They do feel a little bit nicer. They're certainly a little bit bigger, and they retailed for $7 compared to $10, but you know how they do that. You know, never know how much they really cost, but anyway, about $7 for these two. So we're gonna see how well these turn out in a minute. If you are looking for fall-themed items or Halloween-themed items, the Home Goods store is starting to put those things out now. You might want to check out my other video I uploaded today with a walkthrough of what they've started putting out, but it's one of my favorite places to shop. They always have good stuff. Anyway, what else are you going to need? Glue sticks and this polyfill. Now, I get the polyfill from Walmart. I don't usually get this bag. This is a 20-ounce fill bag. It was about between $4 and $5, but they make a 16-ounce one that's around $3-something that I've used in the past. I can't imagine this is much different, but I haven't done the math. Maybe this is a better deal. It's certainly a different quality-looking material, maybe. I don't know. We'll see how it works in a minute. But the first thing we're going to need to do is warm up our hot glue gun. So I'm gonna go ahead and plug that in now, turn it on high, let that heat up for a minute. Now, while that's heating up, I'm gonna show you a couple of the other pillows that I've done in the past. So like I said, this is actually my favorite. I love the way the green is so bright and it coordinates with the little green spider in this pillow. But, you know, usually, again, the dish towels will come coordinating, or they'll just come in a set of two different dishcloths that, you know, are the same. But, you know, if you get two similar ones, you're always going to find patterns that mix and match. So to give you an example of that, this is probably another one of my other favorite combinations. It's, you know, this white pillow with little orange and black and gray skeletons on it. But then this coordinates with it. It's just the, you know, orange and black and white skulls. So, you know, they go together. They're different dishcloths, but they coordinate. All right. Another one. Again, you're always going to find a lot of things in the same, you know, color scheme. It's Halloween. You're going to have lots of oranges and blacks. So like this one, it's got the little raven with the skull on it. You'll notice I started learning to overfill them a little bit. It makes for a much nicer pillow. One day I'm going to fix those original ones that I bought. You know, you could go just a more classic theme, just orange and black. This one's got a little bit of silver thread in it, makes it look a little classier. This one, again, orange black, it's got a little ghost on it. This one, again, is just another little pattern, orange and black, square, check, whatever. You can go for the more fun patterns. This one's just jack-o'-lanterns. This one's just kind of like a, you know, candy corn color type, you know, pattern. Sometimes I do the ones with words on them. This one's like a spider web theme, says double, double, toil and trouble. This one actually, like for instance, it came in a set of two, but it was, you know, one of them was just strictly an entire spider theme, and the other one actually had the words on it. So I'm not sure how I felt about that, but you know, this is kind of a harder color to coordinate with, because it doesn't, I guess it can go with the orange. I mean, it's got orange in it, so but it's not one that I like. This one is another one I don't love, but I kind of like the, you know, all the words, the spooky, ghost, scary, and jack-o'-lantern and so forth. And sometimes you'll find the dishcloths are a little bit larger in size, so you get a little bit bigger of a pillow, and I'll usually like throw this on a bed or something. This one just says trick or treat. This one's just, I don't know how well you can see that in the video, but it's like ghosts and trick or treaters and so forth. So that's it. Those are the only patterns that I have so far, I think, of the ones that I've made. But you know, some of these I have, you know, like four different ones of the same patterns, just so I can put them in different areas, and you know, they all coordinate. You can put it with whatever you want. Anyway, let's see if my glue's starting to warm up. Well, hopefully it is getting hot. Let's go ahead and get started. What you're going to need to do is take your dish towels, just pop them apart here, unfold it. All right, so you have your dish towel. You're going to want to make sure you have pattern going the right way. Now, haven't done this in a year, so let's see if I can remember how we are doing it. Basically, what we're going to end up doing is folding it over. You're going to leave a little bit of space at the bottom because this seam is just going to fold over as well. And I usually like to keep the seam on the bottom side of the back of the pillow. So if I were to do it this way, you can see I've done it upside down. So basically what that means is I need to fold it this way. Just swap it around, leave a little gap on the other side. So when we fold it and we have that seam on the bottom, in the back, we're going to have the pattern the right way. So how much of a gap you leave is really all you need, is just enough to fold this top seam over and hot glue it. So, you know, just where it naturally is already, you know, hemmed, you need a little bit more space than that. Here we go. You can just dry test it, make sure, you know, it's going to fold over and seam. So let's see if our hot glue is working yet. It's starting to get there. Okay, give that a couple more moments. Wow. Let's prepare this one. Now this one's just got the one image on it, so it should be a little bit easier. Now with these, you have to be a little more careful because the image usually goes fairly close to the bottom, and that's going to be where you're going to need to, you know, put your seam. So we want that, again, image, you want the seam on the bottom side, where we're going to fold that over so that the seam is in the back on the bottom. And, you know, it's going to look, ugh. So this one, I'm not sure how it's going to turn out, because if you can see it, it's going to be really close to the bottom. So this might not have been the greatest choice. And I've actually kind of found that now that I'm remembering it, with a lot of these sort of one image patterns. It is almost much better to go with the, you know, the large pattern that's simple, because you're going to see it no matter what. So let's go ahead and seam this one up. All we are going to do, I usually will just, I want to keep my fold where I want it, so I'll just fold over the one side. We take our hot glue, we're just going to run it right down the edge of the towel. All right, I've already made a mistake, but it's no big deal. Because once you glue it, we're just going to press this down, line up the edge as evenly as you can, and just let it dry for a moment. Now, when I said I made the mistake, is I actually glued it close to the far edge, which, I mean, it's fine for now, but we're going to have to glue this seam and fold it over in a minute. So you don't have to go all the way over right now. You just want to go to approximately where, you know, this lands before your fold. So let's go ahead and glue the other side. All right. You know, the more glue the better, but the more you put, likelihood is it's going to, you know, come out of the edge a little bit. It does take quite a bit of glue, so make sure you've got a bunch of these glue sticks on hand. I can't remember how much I paid. I just picked up that new set from Walmart today. They're not very expensive. But you know, you can get them at Michael's, use a coupon. If you have a state that does, you know, free tax holidays for back to school, oftentimes glue sticks will count as a school supply and you'll get an extra discount and not have to pay that sales tax. Anyway, it's drying. So while it's drying, you have two options. You can kind of stuff it now and then glue the seam, but I found that's a little bit more difficult. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to partially glue the flap. So we're going to glue this edge after all, and then start gluing the top edge, but only go about a third of the way in. You can do that on both sides. All right. So we will just fold that over. This is kind of tricky because you want your seam to be even, this bottom flap, so just keep that in mind. If you didn't fold it right to begin with, it's going to be a little bit messier. Anyway, there we go. Now what I've done is I've created just a little opening here, so we're going to be able to stuff in the polyfoam and then glue the edge right at the end. So let's quickly do that again with this one. We'll see how it turns out. So with this one, I'm going to try and go as close as possible to the edge. Just move that out of the way a little bit. All right, so again, we're going to fold this over, just kind of, you know, corner-like like that. Glue the seam. Press the seam down into place with hot glue. Now, clearly, again, this is not sewing. I don't know if you're one of those neat freaks that needs to wash things a lot. But I can't tell you how well this is going to, you know, wash. I've never run any of these pillows through the wash. I'm pretty sure I put them in the dryer before, you know, just to clean off some dust. But I've never had any problems. All right. I'm guessing, for some reason, the glue didn't want to come out too well on that side. So sometimes the seams will split if you don't glue them heavily, but that's okay. If it splits, you can always just pull it apart. The glue will actually just peel right off. So you'll just peel the old glue off, re-glue it, and you'll be set. All right, so again, on the flap, I'm just going about a third of the way on both sides. Keeping this seam very tight to the end. I did not fold it. See, the problem that you're going to get when you kind of do it tightly like that is where it's hemmed already is going to be difficult to fold over. So I can already tell this one's probably messed up because I didn't leave enough room to get over the hem that was there before. Maybe we can fix it with a little bit more glue and squeeze it. Ah, it's a little hot. Don't squeeze it so much that glue will burn you. You also want to be careful with that glue sticking to your creepy cloth that I know you keep on your tables too. So anyway, there we go. I guess it kind of worked out. You can see that pattern okay on this one. So now we're just going to stuff it with polyfoam. Now, the stuff, just pull out in batches and stuff. Just start with the corners, sort of push it in as far as you can into the corner. And, you know, even when you consider the cost of the polyfoam and the you know, the dish towels. This polyfoam again was $4. The dish towels were $7. So that comes out to be what, like 11? We'll just say with tax and everything is $12, glue sticks and all. So I guess that comes out to be about $6 a pillow. To me, I think that's about half price from what I would normally pay if you bought a full pillow in a store. So just go ahead and stuff these. But again, you can find the cheaper dishcloths in different stores. Sometimes, I believe I've seen them at the dollar store too, but I don't think I've ever tried dollar store ones. But that would be nice to find one for a dollar. But you know, I've lost track of how many of these pillows I have when I think about it. And, you know, well, it saved me a lot of money. But then again, it's not really necessary, so I can justify, you know, the expense. Given that it's not necessary, I'm saving money, so it balances out, right? Anyway, so I've got it pretty well stuffed. That took, you know, maybe a third of this polyfoam. I'm just going to stuff a little bit more in there. Like I said, the more you stuff, the better. It will settle just a little bit. Like, it's a little bit lumpy right now. But, you know, as this polyfoam kind of works its way around, the lumps will work themselves out. But you can kind of press it and play with it while you're stuffing it to try and help that along. All right, so there we go. Now the last thing we've got to do is seal up this hole here. So you just kind of press that in as much as you can. Take your glue gun, edge our final bit here on this final seam. And then I usually will just pull it taut and then press it in. I've already burned myself. You might want to be careful and keep a bowl of ice water nearby. So if you do burn yourself, you can just dunk your finger in there. I suppose if you knew how to sew, it probably would turn out a lot better than this. But I don't, so this works for me. And there we go, I have another pillow. And it's a little lumpy, but that'll work itself out. So you can just throw this one right here. Get rid of it. Now this is one of those that I purchased. In fact, it still has the sticker on it. I bought it from the Home Depot on clearance last year. Let's see what it retailed for. It retailed for $12.88. I did get it on clearance for $3.22, and I got a couple of these because, you know, it always looks better to have one on both sides of a sofa or something, I think. So there we go. Let's get rid of that one for now. Put my new one here on the chair. Now let's see how well we can get it to coordinate with my other one here. Again, I was not thrilled with these patterns, but I saw that they started putting them out at the Home Goods, and I've been wanting to do this video for a while, so I just grabbed the ones I liked. I got this because it had the, you know, the coordinating patterns. They did have, most of theirs, in fact, were just, you know, two of the same. Or it would come with, like, one that had a nice Halloween pattern, and the other one would just be a complete solid color, like black. It's just so boring to me. So I got this one so we can see a little bit of variety in the pillows. Now, if I were actually going to be using this, see, so yeah, again, I'm not thrilled by this pattern, so I figured maybe I'll throw it on a chair or something somewhere. But, you know, if I was going to have it on a sofa, I probably would have got two sets to have, you know, one of each pattern on each side of the sofa or something. All right, I'll just finish stuffing this real quick. Almost done. If you have made pillows before, be sure to let me know and how you did it. All right, I think that's good enough. So, all right, so we still have, again, that was about a third of this. This was 20 ounces, so I'm gonna say roughly about 6 ounces a pillow. You'll probably be good, so. But these are also bigger than, you know, some of those other pillows. It's hard to tell really when you're buying them. I suppose, again, if you're good at math and you want to calculate the, you know, per inch cost or whatever, or how much you're going to need per square inch of pillow. I'm sure someone out there probably can do that better than me. Anyway, so I'm going to squeeze it till it naturally folds back together and press it into place. I do that squeezing to let it fold by itself so that I don't burn my fingers. Sometimes it works like this time, sometimes it doesn't, like last time. But you'll see this dries really quickly, and it's actually very strong. I've only had a couple of seams come apart in all the pillows I've done, which has gotta be, you know, 30, 40 of these things. So, oops. Okay, no, I did that right. All right, so these are just pumpkins. For a moment, I thought I put them upside down, but anyway. So you can see, we'll just coordinate together like that on a pillow. I'm sorry, doggy, I gotta get rid of you. Just give you a better view. So, of course, that white is picking up every piece of lint that I've had around, so white's probably not your best choice. Anyway, that's how I do my pillows. I hope I've, you know, given you some ideas and helped you save some money on your Halloween decorating. If you want to see some more of my DIYs going forward, be sure you're subscribed. And I'll see you around then. Happy haunting, everyone. Take care.